Hello and welcome to this brand new series of a Diddy podcast. It's like a miniature version of what we normally do. It's going to be super short. We're going to tell you a story and hopefully it'll just give you some entertainment and you'll love it as much as we love doing it. So let's go on the other side and I'll tell you a story.
Close your eyes. I'm going to take you back.
All right.
To 1996, Brian, and you're working as a maintenance plumber in the East End of London. You're called to a big block of flats in late in the evening, 9 p.m. Tell us what happened.
Well, I had an emergency call to say that the hot water wasn't hot enough in the flat. I'd left you in the car because you just said, oh, I'll come out with you anyway for the ride sort of thing. It was quite a new apartment block. It wasn't an old block of flat.
Was this in the days before mobile phones?
No, I had a mobile phone. It was like a brick.
So I just remember we drove up in this big block of flats. It was just like really dark and everything, wasn't it? Yep. And you just said, just wait in the car. It'll be quite a quick job. Yep. And I'll be back in 10 minutes.
So I go in and there's a girl in there by herself. She was probably 35 years old, something
like
this.
Well, nice that you called her a girl. Well
done.
Yeah,
well, there you go.
Well done, yeah.
She's a girl.
When would you consider going from a girl to a woman? What age would you be?
Well, in your 50s at least, I suppose.
At least 52.
Yeah, at least
anything
52.
Under that and you're still a girl.
Yeah. Turned up, opened the door of the flat, there's a girl there, like we're saying. And immediately you feel like there's something not quite right. And I don't know really what it was.
So did you open the door or
no,
did
she
open the door to you?
And like I said, you know, I'm here from the company I was working for and I've come to have a look at the hot water. Because it was a housing association contract that we had. I say, what problems have you got? And she just said, oh, the water isn't hot enough. Yeah, I had all my tools with me, so you have a digital thermometer. So I opened up the hot water and it was really hot. And I put my thermometer in it. Because sometimes with the lime scale in London, you know, you can run a hot water system for a minute or two and then it'll start to go cold because it can't transfer the heat through quick enough from the pipes because they're fed up with the lime scale. So I put my thermometer on it and I'm like, I've got 62 degrees. And I'm like, well, that's pretty spot on.
What's that in American money?
Well, double it and add 30.
120,
150.
150
degrees Fahrenheit, which is what you're supposed to store your water around about that sort of temperature.
So what's a normal shower?
A normal shower would be around about 38 degrees.
And how 40, hot was her water?
Degrees. Her water was 60 degrees. It's like that's your stored water to kill the bugs in the cylinder that she had. Mm. So if there's any bugs in there, you won't get Legionella. So you should store it at a minimum of 60 degrees. And in the UK, you don't temper it down to 55 like you do in New Zealand.
Anyway,
I'm going like, well, this water is hot. I can't do anything about it. And then she just said, it's not hot enough. And I said, well, what do you mean? She said, it's not hot enough to for when I'm in a bath. And I'm like, it's take your skin off.
No, what did she say? It's not hot enough to...
I can't remember what she said. Sterilise me or
to
something?
To cleanse me.
That was it. Yeah, yeah. I looked over at the bath and it's just like, oh my God. The bath was like almost like black scum in it. Like, you know, it was filthy, the bath. This place wasn't that old. But the place was dirty. She looked a little bit crazy to me. She just had those sort of like, you know, crazy eyes, like, you know, that things were going on there. She walks into the bathroom with me, so I back out the bathroom a little bit. I back out into the hallway of the flat, but she just looked at me as if like there's something weird about me, like, you know. She keeps looking at me and she said, there's someone behind you. And I'm just like, oh my God, what have I let myself into? The bedroom door is slightly ajar. It's kind of dark in there. And the hairs on the back of your neck just go up. I'm just standing there with my thermometer. That's all I've got.
Get away.
Me crucifix. And she's just looking at me as if like, and I'm thinking, I'm just waiting for a knife or something or someone to grab me around the neck, like, you know, and I'm just thinking, oh shit, what do you do? And so she says, someone's behind me. And I didn't want to take my eyes off her because I thought if I look around, she'd either do something, because she did look crazy. Like, you know, she wasn't a huge woman by any stretch of the imagination. She was quite small.
Small ones are the worst.
Oh, they always are, aren't they? And then I just kind of like started putting my head around and then I looked at it and I could see the bed. And in the middle of the bed is just a patch of blood.
You never told me that.
No, I did. It was just, and then, you know, I looked around, there's no one standing behind me. And she just looked again and said, there's someone around you. There's someone by you. And I'm just thinking, oh goodness. And I just went, okay, I need to get my tools and I can't turn the water up. You know, legislation says I can't turn it up any hotter than what it is. You know, I've run it for 5 minutes. You've got hot water. Yes, but it's not hot enough. And I'm like, good grief. It's just like, you know, it's going to take your skin off because it'll make you blister and burn you badly if you get in the bath at that temperature. Mm. So I just like realize there's no one behind me and she is just seeing things. And but she just like, yeah, it just wasn't a very nice experience.
I remember you came back to the car and you were white.
I was white because I just honestly thought someone was going to jump me, you know, and you just like.
So you didn't actually think it was a spiritual thing? Because immediately
I thought someone's, when she said someone's behind you, you know, someone standing behind you. One of the most scary things I've ever sort of, and then when, you know, you look around, there's no one there and she's saying they're still there and you realize it's like she can see someone that I can't.
I would have immediately thought that. I wouldn't have been thinking like, you know, I've got a mate in the back going to club you over the head. I would be thinking there's a ghost behind you.
Who was it? You know, and you just think, yeah.
Thermometer ghost.
Yeah, and I remember.
Hello.